I know you are waiting to watch drones video. 95% of the work has been done. I will definitely upload it in the next video. Today's video is about how it is possible to make an oscilloscope by Arduino. And with it, I will observe, is this oscilloscope really capable of working like a commercial oscilloscope? And as an oscilloscope's output analyzer, I used here Nokia 5110 LCD. Due to the black and white display, it has got a more decent look, at least that is my opinion. Not only you can use it as an oscilloscope, but you can also use it as a function generator. You will also find many options in this oscilloscope. Alright, let's not waste any more time, let's start the video. Stay home and stay safe. This video has been sponsored by GLC PCB. This company make prototype PCB with new generation technology. From here you can order up to maximum 6 layer PCB, and most attractive offer, you can choose any color of PCB absolutely free of cost. You can also choose SMT service to save your time or make your work easier. And of course you can enjoy worldwide shipping in just 7 days. All those fun offer you can enjoy for just $2. I must say, for additional information you can visit their website. To complete this oscilloscope, you will need Nokia 5110 LCD display, and of course you will need Arduino Nano board and some male-to-male wire you will need. This LCD has 48x84 pixels, and it has communicate with Arduino through the serial bus interface. That maximum speed 4 MB per second, and the LCD operate voltage between 2.7 to 5 volt. Okay, let's put the LCD on the breadboard. Then I will put my favorite Arduino Nano on the breadboard. Now it's time to connect the LCD to Arduino help with male-to-male wire. The reset pin of this LCD has to be connected to digital pin 2. Then the CE pin, it has to be connected to digital pin 3. In the same way, DC pin has to be connected to digital pin 4. Similarly, clock and data pin of this LCD will be connected to Arduino digital pin 6 and 7. And I must not forget to connect the 5V power source to this LCD. And if you want to activate the backlight of this LCD, so you can connect the backlight pin of this LCD with 3.3 volt. Okay, you can see the connection between the LCD and Arduino has been completed correctly, and the circuit diagram you will find in the description box as you always get. Now I will try to upload the code of oscilloscope to my favorite Arduino. With that in my mind, I connect my data cable to the laptop and the other end of this cable to my Arduino. After then, I open my Arduino IDE software and see, this is the code of oscilloscope. I have downloaded this code from this website. You can go to this website and gather more information if you want. And if you think this oscilloscope is working very well, then you can make one for yourself. Okay, now time to upload this code. See, as soon as I click the upload button, all the LED inside my Arduino are blinking like crazy, which means my code is being uploaded correctly. After uploading the code correctly, you may see some graphical interface showing on the LCD. It is the interface of this oscilloscope, but I have no option to control this oscilloscope here. So I will add 3 switches here with this Arduino according to this diagram. The button on the right is move down, and the button in the left is move up, and the button in the middle is OK. In this oscilloscope you will find many options such as oscilloscope, function generator, DDS, terminal, so on. Now I want to analyze this oscilloscope correctly, so I will click this scope. See here, the first option is voltage. Here you can select 5V and 1.1 volt to analyze the signal. But I would have the advantage if there was any option of less than 0 voltage. The next option is the time base. It is a very important part of a oscilloscope. It allows you to select between 0 and 8, but the millisecond or microsecond are not specified here. The next option is the parameter, which allows you to monitor wave signal. The next is to shift the timeline up and down. This is DSO136 oscilloscope. I will compare it with my Arduino oscilloscope. Before comparing, I will connect the ground wire with this oscilloscope for a smooth wave signal. As a function generator, I will take the help of my cell phone. From this software, you can get out different type of wave signal such as sine wave, square wave, triangle wave, so on. As an output, I will connect a 3.5 mm jack to my phone, and I will connect the signal to my Arduino's analog pin 3 via 3.5 mm female socket through the 4.7 kilo-ohm resistor. For testing purpose, I will select the wave in triangle and I select the frequency at 50 Hz. And see, the both oscilloscopes are showing triangle wave signal and the signal is also showing 50 Hz. When I am changing the timeline, the triangle wave signal is going to be up. Now if I try to move the timeline up, it will still not going off. After that, I change the signal to 1 kHz. You can see the signal is showing correctly, but the signal wave hop as it was before. Next, I select the signal at 10 kHz. See, the triangle wave in my commercial oscilloscope has changed little bit to the sine wave, which means this oscilloscope does not have capability to measure 10 kHz. But this Arduino oscilloscope is showing somewhat accurate wave, but half wave as before. Then I added my oscilloscope input to the 1 kHz square wave output of my commercial oscilloscope. See, again showing the correct 1 kHz square wave signal, but unfortunately my Arduino oscilloscope is showing half signal. Lastly, I would say this oscilloscope is definitely better than $20 oscilloscope if you can accept the half wave. You can make it for your hobby project, but it is not suitable for commercial work. And guys, even this oscilloscope has a function generator option, it seems like a very good thing for me, because from it you can get output signal from 0 Hz to maximum 10 MHz, and whose duty cycle you can change. Notice this matter with your own eyes. So guys, this is for today. I think you have learned enough from this video. If you have learned something new from this video, then subscribe my channel and hit the bell icon. See you again in another video. Stay home and stay safe.